Hi, my name is Larry Yeager, authorized representative for JG Lubricant Services. Today I want to show you how easy it is to take an oil sample out of a Class A motorhome. This particular motorhome is built on a Freightliner chassis and it has a C7 Cat diesel engine in it. When you buy your sample kit, you'll find in the kit you'll have a bottle that the sample is going to go into. You'll find a length of 1/4 inch plastic tubing that's going to go down the dipstick tube to get to the oil. You'll find an account registration form that will need to be filled out, a label that goes on the bottle that you'll need to fill out, and a choice of labs that is closest to you where you can send your oil sample in. You'll also have a mailing packet for your sample and your account registration form to go into. And you'll also find a set of instruction sheets that will walk you through the oil sample process as well as filling out the registration form. If you don't have a vacuum pump already for doing oil analysis, you'll need one, and it's also available from JG Lubricant Services. We also recommend that you keep a clean rag or paper towel handy, and I would recommend that you wear nitrile gloves or latex gloves to protect your hands from the used oil. So let's get started on the oil sample. The instructions say we need to run the engine for at least 10 minutes to get things warmed up. We've already run this to save us some time. So let's pull the dipstick out. And you'll see this is a very, very long dipstick since it is a diesel pusher. We'll take our 1/4 inch tube and lay it up against the dipstick here to see how long we need. And in this case, this dipstick's long enough, I'm just going to use this whole length of tubing. In cases where your dipstick is a lot shorter, you may want to cut off some of the extra tubing. I'd leave about 10 inches to a foot longer than your dipstick. That way you don't have to pull oil up through a lot longer tubing than necessary. But in this case, we're going to use the full length. We're going to insert this into our vacuum pump. I'm going to insert it in until about 1/2 inch of the tubing comes down into the cavity. And tighten this knob up so that's snug. Take the lid off of our sample bottle and screw it onto the bottom of the vacuum pump. Make sure it's snug. And then we're going to insert this tube down in through the dipstick tube down into the oil pan. Push it down in until it stops. We'll pull it back out a little bit. And then we'll start pumping. And here comes the oil. Now your sample bottle is going to have two lines on it. It divides the bottle into thirds. So you want to get the oil in there so it's just up to the second line. So you have about 2/3 of a bottle of oil so they have adequate supply to do an oil analysis. We're at a third right now. There, we're at 2/3. So I'm going to release this brass knob and pull out our sample tube. I'll let some of that oil drain back into the crankcase that's in the tube, and then we'll carefully unscrew the bottle. Put the cap on the bottle nice and tight. And if there's any oil that got up in our cavity here, use your rag. Clean it out so we don't contaminate the next oil sample that we're going to do. Then we can remove the sample tube from the dipstick tube. And the tube gets thrown away. We don't use it over. We don't want to contaminate the next sample. The next step is to follow the instruction sheet. Fill out your account registration form. Fill out the label that goes onto the bottle itself. Put the bottle and the account registration form into the mailer. And then decide which one of these mailing addresses is closest to your geographical location. Put that label onto the mailer. And if you mail it through the post office, you're going to want to put your return address on the upper left-hand corner. They'll ask you to do that if you don't do it already. And drop it in the mail and wait for your results. And that's all there is to doing an oil sample on a Class A motorhome. Thanks.